Hello everyone, so today we will study calculation of the reactions by graphical method. So let's consider this is a given beam problem. Now we have to draw the space diagram according to this beam. So what we have to do in this problem? First of all, we have to calculate reactions by analytical method, then calculate reactions by graphical method, and we have to compare the results. So here first of all we will draw this diagram with scale and it will be said as space diagram, and for this space diagram we need to decide a scale. So let's consider 1 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. Then we need to redraw this by scale. Let's consider, so this is the beam and this is the load that we have applied. The length over here it will be 1 centimeter and here it will be 3 centimeter. And we know as this is a simply supported beam, the reaction will be only in upward direction. So this graphical method is only for the simply supported beam. So the reaction over here it will be in upward direction. So consider naming this as a point A, this as a point B. The reaction at point A it will be RA and point B will be RB. So here we have to name the space between the forces, and let's consider the space between the force 10 Newton and this RA it will be A. The space between this 10 Newton and RB will be B, and the space between this RA and RB it will be C. So this we have to do as per the Bowes notation, and here this Bowes notation will help us to notify the forces. Then after drawing the space diagram we need to draw a vector diagram. Now, to draw a vector diagram, we need to decide a scale for vector diagram. So, scale for the forces. So, whatever the number of forces which are acting on this beam, for that we have to decide a scale. So, let's say we will decide a scale 1 centimeter is equal to 2 Newton. Then, we have to draw this vertical force that is applied on the beam. So let's draw, consider this as a force of 10 Newton. Then we should name this force according to space, that is AB. So here point A it will be B. Then we have to consider a pole or point at certain distance from this force. Then we need to join these points, end points, that is point A and point O. So here consider this point as point O. So this diagram will be called as a polar diagram. So this diagram will be called as polar diagram. Now what we have to do next? We have to extend the lines wherever the forces are in this beam. It may be reactions as well as the applied forces. So let's extend each line. Then we need to draw a line parallel to this OA in a space A. So line parallel to OA we have to draw in the space OA. Similarly, we have to draw the line parallel to OB in the space B. So here, this OB, we have to draw a line parallel to this OB in this plane. Like this. And we have to close this polygon. So this diagram, it is called as funicular polygon. Okay, so we'll draw a line parallel to this in the polar diagram. Like this. After drawing this line, we will name this point as point C. Then, this length AC will represent the reaction RA. So, this A and C. So, the force between this space will be RA. So, this length will represent reaction RA. And the length BC will represent reaction RB. Because it comes between the space B and C. Then we need to measure this length. Suppose if this length it comes out to be 3.2 centimeter, and the BC length comes out to be 1.8 centimeter. Then we can write directly the reactions RA and RB graphically. Now, we can calculate the reaction RA. So, reaction RA, it will be the length AC. Length AC multiplied by scale. So, this will be equal to 3.2 multiplied by 2 is equal to 6.4 Newton. And the reaction RB will be length BC multiplied by scale is equal to 1.8 multiplied by 2 is equal to 3.6 Newton. So these are the reactions that we have found out by graphical method. Now we have to compare the results. So here, from this figure, the results, that is reaction RA and RB, already have been calculated, and I will write the values for the RA by analytical method. For this problem, it will be 6.67 Newton and RB will be 3.33 Newton. Then we have to compare these analytical results with the graphical results. Now, we have to calculate percentage error for RA. So here, we can write down percentage error for RA. So it will be RA by analytical method, minus RA by graphical method, and then divided by RA by analytical method. This multiplied by 100. So how much will be the error? That we can calculate. So by putting the values of RA and analytical and graphical, so the error comes out to be 4.1%. So this value we have to put over here, and this RA value we have to put over here. Then again, RA analytical we have to put the values and calculate the percentage error. Similarly, we can calculate the percentage error for RB. So here, for RB, again, RB by analytical method minus RB by graphical method divided by RB analytical method multiplied by 100. And this error comes out to be 5.1%. So this is how we have to calculate reactions of a simply supported beam by graphical method when the forces are parallel to each other. Thank you.